Welcome to our church, to what we want to be, a family of love. Welcome to familiar faces, welcome to first timers. Welcome to the old and the young and the somewhere in betweens. Welcome to a place of warm friendship, acceptance and fun. Welcome to a space for silence and solitude. Welcome to a place of joy and laughter. Welcome to an encounter with the unchanging, abundant, steadfast love of God. His generous banquet is lovingly prepared with you in mind. Welcome to the silly and the serious, the honest and the pretending, the lonely and the crowded. Welcome to those who need to be held and those who need to be released. Welcome as you are, a precious part of God's family. Welcome to our church. Father, we thank you that we are loved by you no matter what. You call us to let your love flow through us to other people, including those who may have hurt us. Give us the grace and compassion to do this, and give us understanding as we explore this idea today. Amen. Our first song is Teach Me to Dance, so hopefully you can sing along, or you might even want to dance.
Teach me to beat of your heart, teach me to move in the power of your spirit, teach me to walk in the light of your presence, teach me to dance to the beat of your heart, teach me to love with your heart of compassion, teach me to trust in the word of your promise, teach me to hope in the day of your coming, teach me to dance to see your delight, for I was
Today's reading is taken from the Gospel of Luke. But to you who are willing to listen, I say, love your enemies. Do good to those who hate you. Bless those who curse you. Pray for those who hurt you. If someone slaps you on one cheek, offer the other cheek also. If someone demands your coat, offer your shirt also. Give to anyone who asks. And when things are taken away from you, don't try to get them back. Do to others as you would like them to do to you. If you love only those who love you, why should you get credit for that? Even sinners love those who love them. And if you do good only to those who do good to you, why should you get credit? Even sinners do that much. And if you lend money only to those who can repay you, why should you get credit? Even sinners will lend to other sinners for a full return. Love your enemies. Do good to them. Lend to them without expecting to be repaid. Then your reward from heaven will be very great, and you will truly be acting as children of the Most High. For he is kind to those who are unthankful and wicked. You must be compassionate, just as your Father is compassionate. Do not judge others, and you will not be judged. Do not condemn others, or it will all come back against you. Forgive others, and you will be forgiven. Give, and you will receive. Your gift will return to you in full, pressed down, shaken together to make room for more, running over and poured into your lap. The amount you give will determine the amount you get back.
On Sunday, I thought about and I tried to talk about what it meant to love our enemies and what forgiveness means, and about ways that we are able to do that. One of the things I didn't cover was the end of the passage, which looks at another way that we can learn to be good at reaching out to others. Jesus talks about giving generously and being those who don't hold back from giving. And we see that elsewhere in the passage. He considers that if somebody wants your coat, you give it to them. And if you somebody wants you to carry their pack, you carry it an extra mile. Our possessions and the things that we have can very much control and affect us in ways which are unhelpful to our relationships. They could be something which we hold on to so much that we're not able to really be the kind of people God would want us to be. And learning to be generous, learning not to hold on to what we have, but to allow it to be passed to others or to be shared with others freely and well, is one of the things that enables us to learn to reach out and care for others. I used to belong to a youth club, and I worked in that youth club, and it had as its motto painted on the wall, "People matter more than things." And it's very easy for us to find that things matter more than people, and not spend enough time or energy on people, and spend a lot of time treating people badly because we are just concentrating on things. And I know that's one of my temptations in life, because I love all sorts of things and I love a great variety of things, and I like to spend time being creative and making things and mending things and then using them. And that gives you less time for people. I hope that I do use the things with people and I try to get a good balance. But for some people it's easier than others. Some people are just people. They really don't have any attachment to things. And they may be nearer to what Jesus is talking about here. But certainly, if we allow things to become so important that they hold on to us rather than we have them and use them, then we cannot really learn to love and care for others, and we cannot reach out to those who might want to be our enemies in the way that Jesus talks of here, because what he talks of is being willing to give of the things that matter to you to those who don't matter to you, and so influence them by doing that that they begin to understand what true love is. And if we can do that, we can gain a lot, as we can in other ways that we learn how to forgive and love and share and make sure that our world is a place full of healing. If you want to think more about those things, please do look at the sermon from over the weekend on one of our YouTube channels. But in the meantime, I hope that what you have, you may be grateful for and may use it effectively and well for yourself and for others. And where there is someone who can be blessed by what you have and you don't need it any longer, you will have the strength and freedom to pass it on. Amen. We're going to ask God to come and help us to be full of his love and to know his strength to live our lives in the way that he wants. We have an old hymn done in a more modern way. Here's my life. Here When the Lord comes, he will bring to light the things now hidden in darkness and will disclose the purposes of the heart. Therefore, in the light of Christ, let us admit our failures and weaknesses. Together we pray. Father, we confess that we can easily judge others and put them down. We would hold on to what we think is ours, even when giving it up might help. We struggle to live out your challenging ways in our lives. We allow unforgiveness to blight our world. Father, forgive us and help us to forgive others, no matter who started it or how it began. Give us the strength and security to live lives of radical love and help us to become your people of peace. Amen. Our Father in heaven knows our hearts, strengthens our resolve, relights the fire of goodness and love in us, forgives us and helps us to forgive others and love the unlovable. Amen. We pray for our world and its people. Father, today we especially pray for the Russian leadership and the Russian army. Somehow may they be turned so that they care properly for the people of Ukraine. Give our leaders wisdom and strength to rightly deal with those who would act unlawfully, and enable us to live with the consequence of sanctions. Bring people of love and peace to the fore, and enable compassion and goodwill to win out. We pray for those whose lives are blighted by vengeance, whose hearts are hardened by hatred, who misjudge and are misjudged. May your challenge of reconciliation become real to them and the hope of forgiveness turn true. We pray for a spirit of generosity which exceeds any which is natural, an ability to transform for good even the hardest and darkest places. We ask that love may win out and compassion become the guide to all we do and say. We agonize over the questions of truth, justice and mercy which face your community, the Church. May we find ways to live in faith and love which truly reflect your holy nature and which show your view properly to our world. These prayers we ask through Jesus, who lived out true love for all. Amen. Thank you, God, for loving me. Help me to show my love for you by being kind to other people, even when I don't feel like it. In Jesus' name, amen. We pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Dad in heaven above, let everyone look up to you and the area where you are in charge grow. May what you want happen on earth as perfectly as it does in heaven. Please give to us what we need for today. Forgive us when we think or do wrong things, just as we don't hold it against those who hurt us. Guide us away from whatever we might want but is unhelpful to us. And protect us from all that is nasty and destructive. For for you are in charge of everything. You have the power to do it, and you are awesome. You always were, you are now, and always will be. Amen. Our final hymn is Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone, the old hymn again with a slightly modern twist. May your heart be at peace and your mind be at rest. May you be confident in who you are and share God's gifts of light, hope and grace with those you meet and those you pray for. May the blessing of God fill your hearts with hope this day and evermore. Amen. We join together in this prayer. Dear Father God, thank you that we are loved and forgiven by you. We know it's hard to love those who have hurt us. Give us strength to love our enemies and to do good to those who hate and hurt us. And help us to be people of compassion, reaching out to all from a place of great security. We ask in Jesus' name.